Garden, you know what I'm saying?
The lineup.
The lineup. What'd you say?
Chris Paul.
Yeah.
And it's like, you know, also
shit. Yeah, they know. Yeah, right. The hopeless. Yeah, the hopeless. Go ahead.
It says, let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud upon their beds. Let the high praises of God be in their mouth and a two-edged sword in their hand. To execute vengeance upon the heathen and punishments upon the people. To bind the kings with chains and the nobles with fetters of iron.
Right, so in the kingdom, we're going to take all the nobles, all the leaders, the kings of the earth, of all these, all the nations on earth, all the kings, the leaders, the elite.
Give them some examples.
They get,
they don't know.
The senators, you know, politicians. The Rothschilds, yeah, the Rothschilds. All these rich devils that controlling the earth got you in slavery. They're all going into chains. Man, your boy bugged out, bro. He mentally retarded.
To bind the kings with chains and the nobles with fetters of iron, to execute upon the judgment written, dishonor have all his saints, praise ye Yahweh.
Yeah, so we out here praising Yahweh Basham, Yahweh Shah. That's the name we coming in.
Right. You guys like to repent, come back to the Lord, to the Most High. Can't be like his heathen, man. Straight one gave you gate the next day, man. Cool. Change y'all's ways and come back to the laws of the Most High.
And have faith in y'all shot.
That's right. You gotta have faith.
Gotta have faith. Hey, look, he didn't make no sense. Isaiah 60:14. The sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come bending unto thee. And all they that despise thee shall bow themselves down at the soles of thy feet, and they shall call thee the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel, whereas thou hast been forsaken and hated, so that no man went through thee. I will make thee an eternal excellency, a joy of many generations. Thou shalt also suck the milk of the Gentiles, and shall suck the breast of kings. And thou shalt know that I am the Lord thy Savior, thy Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob.
And Gentiles of other nations, not Israel. Niggas like vocab belongs, confused with the scripture. Slaves. That's what we design. What does it say? The patience and the faith of the saints. To have slaves.
No. It says there's a faith and patience.
You're gonna have slaves one day, man. I'm sorry? You're gonna have slaves.
Would I like to have slaves one day?
Yeah, right. You live in karma?
I know karma, yeah.
Hey, no karma.
So the grandparents want to get the slave.
You're the
sword.
Then they
should come back to the people. So you said forgive them for it? I didn't say I was forgive
them. So what should be done to them? If I go kill that man right there, Should not be going to prison or something?
So you just let murderers run around free, right?
I didn't say that, but I'm just trying to understand. I was a peace officer standing here.
Let me ask you a question. Did Miriam have left to
eat? No, Miriam teaching.
Okay, this is Miriam. It was
Numbers 12, and I'm going to start at 3, a lot of reading here, okay? Now the man Moses is very meek and upon the man which were above the face of the earth. And the Lord spake suddenly unto Moses and unto Aaron and unto Miriam, come out ye three unto the tabernacle of the congregation, and their three, and they three came out. And the Lord came down in a pillar of a cloud, and stood in the door of the tabernacle, and called Aaron and Miriam, and they both came forth. And he said, hear now my words. If there be a prophet among you, I, the Lord, will make myself known unto him in a vision, and will speak unto him in a dream. My servant Moses is not so, who is faithful in all mine house. With him will I speak mouth to mouth, even apparently, and not in dark speeches. And in the similitude of the Lord shall be he behold. Wherefore then were ye not afraid to speak against the servant Moses? And the anger of the Lord was kindled against them, and he departed. And the cloud departed from off the tabernacle, and behold, Miriam became leprous. So before she became leprous, what was she? She was a woman.
They changed her nationality too, right?
So because when she changed from color to left and white, that did her nationality change?
I would say so.
Okay, she remained an Israelite, but she was white though, right? So, here we go.
The reason I asked is because generally when you see Israel, Hebrew Israelites out here, right, you don't see them with a Caucasian.
Oh, right.
I don't have anything against Israel.
Well, who are you talking about?
Israel.
We've been out here longer than anybody in Columbus. You know that.
No. I'm not from Columbus.
Oh, so
I just been here 3 weeks. But I'm from Indianapolis, Indiana. And so I don't think you all are doing a bad thing. I'm a Moor. I think we're the same people.
We are, but not the Moor is not a nationality.
Moor is
not a nationality. You can't just make up your own nationality.
Moor is a color.
No, you can't. You just cannot make
up the Declaration of Human Rights. It's all.
No, I'm serious. Listen, man. I understand that. But you can't make up a nationality. All the nations of the Lord already made every nation. So how do you even make a lot of nations?
The Moor is just a color. That means a color brown.
Right. That's all it means, man.
That's what the word means. Right. Unless you want to get to...
You are an Israelite.
Moor brought me to the promised land. Yeah, it's over here.
That's true. Yeah.
He set us all up with this. You know what I'm saying? For that money. Moor's for the money.
It was a dirty
one. I can admit that. He's a dirty one. There's map makers and witch. You know what I'm saying?
Dirty
Moor. There's people that
stuff.
I'll never give up my Moorish American nationality, but I think that you're doing good work. I think that what you're doing, that using the Bible to expose the system, right, is what is supposed to be done.
True.
And even though we have a difference in nationality, I still feel that your heart's in the right place and that you're doing a good work.
I can dig it.
I mean,
so if my heart's in a good place, then you're doing the opposite, and that means.
I didn't say.
Morris, whatever. You said that we got a good heart, so I mean, you should be going this side instead of going that Morris crap.
No, and the reason why I won't come back with an attack is because I don't think it's crap, and I don't think what you're doing is crap. See, if we.